Said, I was with him in a bike in Delhi. It was very scary because there were trucks that were bearing down on us. Navjyoti would just say yes and overtake it as if all trucks would respect. Then I said, this is terrible the way it is. He said, no, 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 I'm a very safe driver. He said, never had any accident? No, no, no. And then he said, almost never. I said, almost never means kab kya hua? Only once gir gaya, no? Nothing hua. It turned out that the only instance that he had fallen down, Dharampalji was the pillion rider, no? So anyway, so very great adventures. So personally, I think that it's wonderful to be here and meet all these people. To me, what it means that one doesn't try to emulate him, because I don't think it's possible. But I think that is something that we should all celebrate, because we talk when we read about the glorious past within quotes, we come across some personalities about whom we say that they seem to be brilliant, having touched so many subjects. There is a saying about Maharishi Vedavyas saying, Vyaso Chishtam Jagat Sarvam. Everything in the Jagat has been touched by him in some way or the other. It's his Uchishta, you know. So is it possible to have personalities like this who have touched so many things, so profoundly reflected and had some deep insights to share, you know? Sometimes you look at these historic personalities and say that bakwas and how could they be, but then you come across a personality in the year 2017, you seem to be doing that, no? So you look back and say that, yeah, it's possible. So I'm just very happy to be here to join this celebration and remembering of Navjyoti. No? Thank you for all this occasion and sharing all these very precious memories with us.
Yeah, that was A.V. Balasubramaniam from Chennai. Professor Shankar? Yeah, please come.
Those of you who have not met me, I'm Shankar. I met Navjyoti during the 1980s. Some incidents which I just want to quickly recall. Through, I don't know, by accident or by design, I was to run this Congress on Traditional Sciences first in 1993. So, I mean, it had some 11, 12, divisions, and I knew nothing of any of them. You know, there was theoretical sciences, there was mathematics, there was metallurgy, there was, you name it, all of it was new to me. Anyway, since I was to run this show, so I'd go around and get some money to do whatever work was proposed. So, sometime in July of 93, all of us landed in Delhi in his office in Nistats. The idea was to meet the minister and get some money for this Congress. That was the... So morning, from the meeting was supposed to be at 4 or 5 o'clock, and we were all there in the morning. We have to, make a proposal to the minister so that he give us some money. After spending 2-3 hours with Navjyoti, and I just went out and called Navjyoti and asked him, hey Navjyoti, do you think we get anywhere? He said, what do you mean? The job is done, he said. I said, what job is done? Money is there. The minister is going to give you money. Why are you worried? You just go and talk. So religiously, of course, Rajiv was there, many others were there. And then at the end of the whole show, I was given some 2-3 minutes. So I just asked the minister, Minister, we have everything in place, but we need money. Will you give us? Something like that. The minister said, yes, go ahead. So, end of the day when we came out, and I told Navjyoti, Navjyoti, you seem to have worked out something which I never thought could ever be done. So, it went on like this, a person with so much optimism, that was his greatness, a great amount of optimism. And a few days before the Congress, I called Navjyoti and said, hey, listen, there are some 928 people are going to come to this, to IIT Bombay campus. And how do I going to manage 900 people to be housed in this place? Even during the Science Congress, apparently, so many people did not come. For the first time, so many people were coming into IIT Bombay. he was elated. Wow, fantastic. Fantastic. I said, what do you mean fantastic? I am struggling and you are saying it's fantastic. What is this? This is you're doing something which people have never thought of. And he told me what? He went to the next level and said, listen, what we need to do is you give me money, he said. What do you want money for? See, I will create a daily news, like what happens in the Science Congress, so that everybody knows what happens on a daily basis. I asked him, how much money do you want? He made give some money, and of course he came and did a fantastic job and all that. But still I was very worried during the event. So I told Navjyoti, listen, there are some 800 people already, and people are struggling to find place to stay. The bedding is not there, it's winter time, and hostels are overflowing. And he said, oh, fantastic. A great job has been done. So the optimism of this great fellow, I was pleasantly reminded of his very smiling face, always new information and so on. On this day, in front of all of you, I pay my respects to him. Thank you.
Bajaj, would you? Dr. Bajaj from CPS. Navjyoti, it's very long ago. I was a child then. I was 75 when I was a guest student for 1 year in IIT Kanpur. I was not a regular student there. I would be 23 years and Navjyoti will be 19, 20? 18, is it? And he behaved like an 18-year-old, actually. I remember that I met many of these people who are sitting here. I met in that 1 year there when I spent in IIT Kanpur. And I remember having several discussions with in that one. I maybe after that 1 year, I have not had that much discussions with Jyoti, what I had in that 1 year there in IIT Kanpur. And I think IIT Kanpur soil has some philosophical intent about it. Because he used to tell me about what he is doing for his M.Tech, I think of M.Tech, that there's some archaeo-nuclear reactions that he was studying. And he used to make this, I tried to fix him, that what is the technicality of it? You tried to explain it to me, and he was making that look so philosophical, that work. Well, I could never pin it down that what exactly is getting done. It'll go into all kinds of disciplines while he was talking about that very technical project of his. I don't know if it got completed or not. It got completed, yeah. But he had a philosophical bent of mind from the beginning. I remember later once I was in a committee where Navjyoti was made a presentation, and after his presentation was over, there was this Abid Hussain, who used to be the chairman of NISTEDS, and P.K. Mukhopadhyaya, who really liked Navjyoti. And both of them said that whatever his work, but he is a philosopher. That even Abid Hussain said that we have no doubt that he is a philosopher. That his mannerism, his style of speaking, his just being is a philosopher. I personally am not a philosopher. I am not a philosopher, actually. I would have had some formal training in philosophy, but Navjyoti was a philosopher. I am not of that. In fact, I don't even have an IIT Kanpur background to be called a philosopher. So, what I am thinking of is that he was younger to all of us. In fact, there are younger people here, but
to all of us who were talking, no, he was much younger. We are still here and he is not there. I'm sure if he were in this position, he would have philosophized about it. We can only grieve about it. He would have certainly philosophized about it. It ends in an unjust situation, certainly. I don't know whether it fits into that issue of what you were mentioning, that he had a sense of that everything is justiciable. I don't know whether this is justiciable or not. Should not happen. Should not happen. But there's not much else I can say, that normally life is unjust.